Just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on for.
In our planning for these centenary celebrations, we wanted to leave a legacy, both a physical legacy of this generation of worshippers at Parktown North, and also a legacy for the future in other ways, in more spiritual ways, although I think the window is just something that we can leave as a legacy of the spirituality of this generation, the many people who have worshipped here. And I think it's just beautiful as it encapsulates not only the centre of our faith, the cross, the crown of thorns, but it also incorporates the communion, which has been celebrated here for 100 years. And it incorporates the lighthouse, which speaks of our mission statement as a church, that we are a lighthouse and a refuge for all people in this community.
Parktown North Methodist Church, celebrating 100 years of ministry and service. We are 100 years young. So what about the next 100 years?
It's been a wonderful for me to arrive in this community on the 100th year of its life. And it has its challenges, but this year has been filled with so much celebration. Such a legacy of faith, hope, compassion, care for the community. I do think that is what we can build on. Some of the evident challenges are that the congregation has relatively aged and we hasn't been attracting much of a younger audience. I do hope that we can begin to engage a younger generation, that the church becomes a multi-generational church and a multicultural church in its essence. But that's an exciting opportunity for us as a community to move towards.
To try when your arms are too weary to reach the unreachable star. This is not where to follow. A pause to be willing to march, march into hell for that heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest that my heart. Scars still strove with his last ounce of courage.